Hey, this is Dev from Bogren Digital, and today we're checking out how we can use an iPad with our Kemper units to tweak our two Madsen signature Kemper profiles. As you probably know, Kemper dropped a Houdini on the world when they revealed dormant Wi-Fi capabilities within their units. Now that the iOS app has been released, we can utilize this capability within our Kemper units to control them remotely. The Kemper stage will be able to establish a direct Wi-Fi connection to your iPad. But for rack, head, power rack, and power head users, you'll need a direct cabled LAN connection to your router. But here's a tip. If you've got a Wi-Fi booster with a cabled LAN connection, you can actually plug it into that too. And it will actually work. Once you've got all that sorted in accordance to your own rig, you can jump over to the App Store and download the Kemper Rig Manager Profiler Editor app. That's a mouthful. Say that one 5 times fast. Once that's done installing, you can jump in, and when prompted, you can establish a connection with your Kemper unit. Now, let's have a gander at the goods. So right off the bat, you'll probably notice the similarities between this app and the desktop version of Rig Manager. Fundamentally, they're exactly the same, but this has the added benefit of a little bit of physicality, a streamlined UI, and the ability to take it anywhere that your Wi-Fi connection will allow. At the top of the screen, we have our profile selector, where we can cycle through our profiles. Directly below that, from left to right, we have our entire input chain. Much like the front face of the Kemper unit, we start with our rig settings, where we can control some general things, and then we move along to our input, where we can control our noise gate settings. Next, we have our 4 pre-effects blocks that we can tailor to our liking. In the center of the chain lives our amp block, where we can fiddle with some EQ and tweak some deeper settings, and then we have our cap where we can tweak some related parameters. And following that are the 4 post effects blocks, which we can again tailor to our own preferences. If you want to enable an effect, or change one, what you can do is click on the effect and tap it once again to enable it. Then if you want to change it, you can come over to the icon on the left hand side, tap that to reveal the effects list, and select whatever your heart desires. I'm going to take this opportunity now to find a profile from the 2 Madsen Signature Kemper pack that utilizes a variety of effects. I'm a sucker for simplicity, so I'm gonna trust that Tua has my back here. I think number 16, Ed Mess, fits the bill nicely. Metal! Alright, let's get in there and fuck some shit up. So I'm gonna jump in and I'm gonna crank up the noise gate just a little bit. We're gonna up the threshold here. We're gonna jump in, we're gonna enable this vintage chorus, and I'm gonna come over to the post effects, and we're gonna enable the rotary speaker and the 2-tap delay. So now I've got that sounding like a gnarly, soaking wet alien lead. But maybe it's not quite into ectoplasmic gargle territory, like I'd like it to be. So I'm gonna jump into each of those effects and crank up the mix and volume levels. But if we feel like we've strayed too far from Tua territory, we can jump back to the default profile by just hitting the dotted icon at the very top of the iPad and hitting Undo All Rig Changes. One final really cool thing we can do is mess with the morph function. This can be used to create some really unique effects, like ambient swells, effects bursts, or separate gain stages within the same profile. Let's say I wanted to create a morph setting where I engage a tube screamer and a delay. All I've got to do is jump into my app, make sure the morph slider is to one side, and set the setting that I want accordingly. Then slide the morph to the other side, and reset the same parameter so that you see 2 different bars. If I can get that going. There we go. So this should engage the tube screamer. We'll do the same with the delay. Sliding the morph. I like. Once again, to revert to the Tua Madsen certified bass profile, all you need to do is click the dotted icon at the top and select Clear All Morphs. So are you ready to sink your teeth into this juicy apple? Let us know in the comments below. Tack and skål!